Welcome. We begin this video by sharing some basic facts about Prince George's County, many of which you may be familiar with. Prince George's County is located in the Washington metropolitan region, east of the District of Columbia. It is one of five counties that surround the city, including Montgomery, Anne Arundel, Calvert, and Charles counties in Maryland, as well as Arlington County in Virginia. I-495, the Beltway, circles the district and links Prince George's County to the D.C. metropolitan area. With a land area of approximately 500 square miles, Prince George's County has a population of about 865,000 people, with just over 300,000 households. 15 existing metro rail stations are located in the county, and 11 new light rail stations will be added with the planned Purple Line. Prince George's County is anticipated to grow substantially in the next decades. The recent plan update, Plan Prince George's 2035, was a result of a countywide effort to plan for this growth and channel it to create regionally competitive communities of choice. This effort, Envision Prince George's, was attended by hundreds of participants. One of the central questions discussed at Envision Prince George's was, where should the new downtowns of Prince George's County be located? Prince George's Plaza area was selected as one of three new downtowns and as one of five high-priority transit-oriented development locations. Having talked about key facts of the county as a whole, let us now focus on the Prince George's Plaza area. Approximately 5,000 people, including 2,100 households, currently live in the area. This population includes children and working-age adults and is almost evenly split between families and non-families. The area is ethnically diverse, with 61% of residents being African-American, 22% Latino, and 10% white. The area's housing is predominantly rental. Several communities are located near the Prince George's Plaza area. These include the city of Hyattsville, whose boundaries are both within and outside the study area, the towns of University Park, Riverdale Park, and College Park, and the neighborhoods of Lewisdale, Langley Park, and Chillum. Several major roads run through or are adjacent to the study area, connecting residents and commuters to jobs, retail, and the region. These include East-West Highway, Bellcrest Road, Adelphi Road, Queens Chapel Road, and University Boulevard. The evolution of the area from farmland to the present began with the construction of the mall at Prince George's in 1959. Originally an open-air shopping center, the mall has been expanded several times. Today, it is a thriving retail center for the surrounding communities with several anchor stores. Next to the mall is University Town Center, begun in 1964. Designed by the renowned architect Edward Durell Stone, the project was planned as a residential, commercial, employment, and social complex. Several churches are in the study area. Built in the 1960s and 70s, these structures share the modernist architecture popular at the time. An important asset of the Prince George's Plaza area are the three schools that lie within or just adjacent to it. These include the Northwestern High School, Nicholas Oram Middle School, and the recently opened Edward M. Felagy Elementary School. There are also existing civic uses nearby, including the Hyattsville Public Library and the Prince George's Plaza Community Center, which is the oldest commission-owned recreation center in the county. With the opening of the Prince George's Plaza Metro Station in 1993, the area was connected to the region via transit. The metro station includes a parking garage with just over 1,000 spaces and has an average weekday ridership of about 5,000 patrons. Located just east of the Prince George's Plaza area is the northwest branch of the Anacostia River. A ridge separates the study area into two smaller watersheds. As the land in the area gets developed, these developments must respect these drainage areas and maintain them when proposing solutions for handling stormwater runoff. The Prince George's Plaza area also has two streams whose 100-year floodplains are shown in red on the map. On the west side is an unnamed tributary to the Northwest Branch that is located on land owned by MNCPPC. The second stream is a tributary to Wells Run that is located west of Adelphi Road on the eastern portion of the area. This stream is piped under Adelphi Road and flows on the surface from there to the south. The land within the area boundaries where the stream channel is located is privately owned, with areas adjacent to the stream being wooded and containing a variety of wildlife. Historic photos from the 1930s show the area was primarily farmland and that much of the Northwest Branch stream valley was not wooded. The stream valley has reforested over time and the overall tree canopy coverage has increased by more than 18%. However, vast areas of the study area still contain no trees. Over 50% of the study area is covered by asphalt, concrete, and other paved surfaces. Over 90% of the mall at Prince George's is covered by such surfaces. Since the majority of the Prince George's Plaza area was built before modern stormwater management requirements were in place, very little of the water that runs off the land is treated to remove pollutants or controlled to reduce flooding. Based on state standards, the water quality in Northwest Branch is considered very poor, and the water quality in Lower Northeast Branch is considered poor. Flooding of downstream properties within the Lower Northeast Branch watershed has also been reported. Both water quality issues and water quantity issues need to be addressed within the Prince George's Plaza area. The area is home to the Prince George's Plaza Metro rail stations and numerous bus routes. It is bisected north from south by East-West Highway, which connects adjacent communities and Montgomery County. Bellcrest Road brings significant traffic down a corridor separating east from west. The Northwest Branch on the west is a rich, green, natural landscape, but limits connections to the neighborhoods to the west. The Metro Rail Corridor likewise limits connections to the south. There is a significant difference in the amount of traffic along East-West Highway on either side of Queens Chapel Road. To the west, as far as Riggs Road, the road has little more than half of the traffic than on the east. This dramatic change in the amount of traffic, 27,000 vehicles a day west of Queens Chapel Road versus 47,000 vehicles a day east of Queens Chapel Road, presents an opportunity to reimagine the character of East-West Highway. Currently, street connections within the area are very limited. Bellcrest Road is already heavily used as an alternative north-south route to Adelphi Road, while East-West Highway is the only continuous east-west road into and beyond the study area. Toledo Terrace provides for local connections, but its curve and the amount of residences along it limits its use as a major vehicular roadway. Local and through vehicle trips are currently focused on Bellcrest Road and East-West Highway, with poor connections to local businesses and residential communities. More roadway connections would provide many advantages to the Prince George's Plaza area, including better access, better distribution of traffic, more travel choices, increased development value, and overall, a more walkable, community-oriented place. There are many gaps in the network of sidewalks throughout the area, including along East-West Highway and Toledo Terrace. Major intersections generally have clear crosswalks and walk signs, but pedestrians must wait long periods of time and cross long distances with significant risk. The iconic elevated pedestrian bridge spans East-West Highway, providing a pedestrian connection between the mall and the metro station. However, narrow stairways and unattended elevators are intimidating to pedestrians, especially at night. The vast parking lot of the mall provides few clear pedestrian routes leading directly to the stores and the surrounding streets. The brick wall along East-West Highway on the mall property is also a barrier to pedestrians, especially students who often jump over it to get to the public schools south of East-West Highway. There are no bike lanes within the Prince George's Plaza area and no direct connections to the Northwest Branch Trail that runs just west of the area and connects to regional trails. Aside from the few bicycle parking facilities at the Prince George's Plaza Metro Station, there is limited bicycle accommodation elsewhere in the area. Demand for the covered bike racks at this metro station is high, with cyclists chaining bikes to railings and columns when existing racks are filled. There are over 10,000 public parking spaces within the Prince George's Plaza area, split between WMATA, University Town Center, the Mall, Metropolitan Shops, and multiple residential complexes. The parking garage at the metro station sees less than 50% of its spaces filled on weekdays and is almost empty on weekends. As part of our research, we also conducted a transit survey and received responses from over 350 mall employees, area residents, and metro users. A summary of the results includes the following. Most surveyed residents and workers use transit or walk while traveling within the Prince George's Plaza area, with less than 20% choosing to drive. 41% of surveyed residents use transit frequently to get to work. Patrons still primarily drive to the mall at Prince George's. 64% of those surveyed drove to the mall. Residents give the study area low marks in perceived safety, especially including the safety of crossing East-West Highway. There is a strong desire to improve the use of transit. 74% of residents and 42% of workers stated they are willing to try transit. As we envision a new downtown in the Prince George's Plaza area, it is important to highlight the existing economic conditions and future trends. These trends will help us determine what type of new development will be successful. The mall at Prince George's is a strong retail center with successful anchor stores, but it is not well connected to the surrounding communities. There is also market demand for more dining options and additional retail in the area. Although University Town Center has recently struggled to successfully lease retail space, new ownership and the opening of the new Safeway store on East-West Highway will hopefully bring more patronage in the near future. The office market in the area has been shrinking due to the downsizing of local and federal government and other factors. There appears to be limited demand for new office space. However, new concepts such as co-working spaces, flex space, and small offices might be options to capture new business. Multifamily housing, on the other hand, has seen a lot of growth in the area, and we anticipate substantial new growth in the future as well. This shift from single-family housing to multifamily development is likewise occurring throughout the county. Multifamily residential development projects such as the Mosaic, Post Park, and 3350 at Altera have recently been completed and more are in the planning stage. We anticipate significant new growth in this area over the next 15 to 20 years. As we noted at the beginning, the transformation of the Prince George's Plaza area into a new downtown is an important goal of the planned Prince George's 2035 effort. Downtowns are walkable, attractive, and vibrant places. While some of these qualities exist in the area today, some are missing. We know new development is likely to occur in the area. How can we channel that development to create a vibrant downtown? How can we use it and the energy it will bring to improve the quality of its places? What are the near-term issues that need to be addressed? Tonight and tomorrow, we'll be listening to your ideas about how we best make that transformation. We are looking forward to having that conversation with you.